சுந்தர் அவர்களா? சிம்பல். So this is an inclined plane at an angle of 37 degrees. There is no coefficient of friction. And there is a body of mass of 5 kg which is released from here. Okay. Then what is the acceleration with which this body is coming downwards? Clear ma? And the second question is, how much time it will take to come downwards? And what is the final velocity with which it touches the ground? When, what is the length of the inclined plane? When length of the inclined plane is 10 meters. That is the question. Clear? So anybody, how can I say, how can I do this calculation? With what acceleration it is coming down, ma? Earth is pulling this body, no? Why it is coming downwards? Because Earth is pulling this body. So can I say acceleration is g9.8? Can I say? Yes. See, Earth is pulling this body in which direction? Earth is pulling this body in downwards direction. Okay? So weight mg is in downward direction. Or you can say acceleration due to gravity, g is also a vector quantity, no? Acceleration is also a vector quantity. So g is also acting in downwards direction. Okay? But body is moving in this direction, no? Body is moving along the inclined plane. So this acceleration is not responsible for producing this acceleration. Are you able to understand? E acceleration, no? E motion ki 100% responsible kaadu. Then what I have to do? Split this one. So split this g value into two components. How I can split? So this is how I can split two vectors, no? You should be masters of splitting. Splitting perfect ga undali. Splitting ee raledante inge em laabham ledu chadu. Clear? So if this angle is 37, this angle is also 37 degrees only. Clear, Nama? And this is my G value. This is my G value, no? So this G I can split into G cos theta. And this one I can split into G sin theta. Or if you want to split weight vector, weight also same vector only. Clear, Nama? Weight I can split into mg sin theta. And this one will become mg cos theta. Are you able to understand? Now can you say, what is G sin theta here? What is meant by g sin theta? What is the work of g sin theta? G sin theta is the acceleration which is responsible for pulling the body downwards. Clear? See, what is the direction of g sin theta? G sin theta is exactly downwards the inclined plane, no? So nothing but this acceleration is nothing but g sin theta. Or we can say the weight component which is pulling the body downwards is nothing but mg sin theta. Are you able to understand? So directly you can say the acceleration which is pulling the body is a g sin theta. Clear? Or you can say, or you can derive this one also. How I can derive? Mg sin theta is the force which is pulling this body downwards, no? Total weight of the body is not pulling the body downwards. Total weight is not pulling the body downwards. Weight vector I have split into two components. One component is pushing the inclined plane. One component is pulling the body downwards. Clear, no? So I can say mg sin theta is the only force which is pulling this body downwards. Are you able to understand? Mg sin theta is the only force which is acting on this 5 kg body in downwards direction. Is there any other force? Adi kaakunda inkemanna force unda? No, that is the only force. So therefore I can say mg sin theta is the only force which is pulling the body downwards, and mg sin theta becomes the net force. Net force formula? Mass into acceleration. Clear now? So m and m if you can cancel, then what is the value of a I got? G sin theta. Same answer I have written without any derivation also, no? Clear now? So g is also vector quantity. Acceleration due to gravity also vector quantity only. Acceleration is always a vector quantity. Split that acceleration into two components. Are you able to understand? So g sin theta, g cos theta. Or you can do in force method also. What is meant by force method? Mg sin theta is the force which is pulling the body downwards, no? So mg sin theta is the net force. Net force formula, mass into acceleration. So acceleration I got, A is equal to g sin theta. Clear, no? So theta value is already given, no? So therefore substitute that value. A is equals to g value I will take approximately 10, and angle is 37, so I will write sin 37. So 10 into sin 37 value 3/5, so 6 meter per second square. Clear one? So this is the acceleration with which body is coming downwards. In the acceleration to the kindi kravadam start up. Clear number? And what is meant by 6 meter per second square already we have understood. No, 6 meter per second square means what? 6 meter per second per second. That's all. 6 meter per second means? Velocity of this body increases by 6 meter per second every second. For every second, its velocity increases by 6 meter per second. That is the meaning of acceleration. First second, velocity is 0. At 0 second, velocity is 0. After first second, its velocity will be 6. After second second, its velocity will be 6 plus 6, 12. After third second, it will be again 12 plus 6, 18. That is called as acceleration. Acceleration meaning adegada? How velocity is changing with respect to time. Time tho paati, velocity ala marutu undi ane the acceleration. So I got an acceleration of 6 meter per second square. Are you able to understand? Okay. So next question, what he is asking, time taken to come down. How can I calculate? Time taken to come down is how much? Come on. Chappandi, length of the inclined plane is already given. No? First of all, this is what kind of motion? Uniform motion or non-uniform motion? Non-uniform motion. How can you say it is non-uniform motion?
Acceleration.
Because acceleration is there, no? Wherever you see acceleration, definitely it is non-uniform motion. So accelerated motion means how many equations we have?
Four.
Four equations we have. What are the four equations? V is equals to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square. All these four equations we have, number. So out of these four equations, which equation shall I use to calculate a time? Displacement is already given, no? Length of the inclined plane is already given. Acceleration I have calculated. I want to calculate time. All of them are present in which equation? S is equals to ut plus half at square. Only in this equation only, we have displacement also, we have initial velocity also, we have time also, and we have acceleration also. Clear now? So displacement is a 10. Initial velocity? When body is released, its velocity is 0, it doesn't have any velocity. 0. Plus a half. Acceleration? 6. Time taken? I don't know. Clear now? So 10 is equals to 3t square. So t square is equals to 10 by 3. So t is equals to root 10 by 3 seconds. That is our answer. Clear now? So body will take a time of root 10 by 3 seconds to come downwards. Clear? Then he is asking the third question. What is the third question? What is the velocity with which it touches the ground? That one how can I calculate? With what velocity it touches the ground? Which relation? Definitely I can use the relation v square minus u square is equals to 2as. Clear now? Or just you can use v is equals to u plus at also, because already I have calculated time now. Time is already there, no? Use u, v is equals to u plus at. Initial velocity, 0. Acceleration, 6. Time taken, root 10 by 3. So this is the final velocity. 6 root 10 by 3 meter per second. So with this velocity, the body is going to touch the ground. Understood, Nama? Very simple calculation. So this question is totally based on splitting the vectors into two components. Clear? That's it. So if you don't understand it, vectors ki malli pondi, malli splitting. Can you say what is the normal reaction acting on 5 kg body? Mg cos theta. How can you say? Normal reaction mg cos theta ani ela cheptaru? Sima. This is the weight of the body, nama mg. Mg is the weight of the body, which is always acting towards the center of the earth. Clear? So this mg, I have split into two components, mg cos theta and mg sin theta. What is mg sin theta doing? Mg sin theta is pulling the body downwards. Ikkadunna vector ni, ikkadiki displace chestunnanu nenu. The vector which is present here, I have displaced here. I can displace vectors anywhere, nama. Anywhere I can displace the vector, just its direction and magnitude should not change. Clear now? Then what about mg cos theta? What is this mg cos theta doing here? What is the function of mg cos theta? Yen chestundadi intaku? Chudandi, see the direction. If you see the direction, you can understand what is the work of mg cos theta. Mg sin theta is pulling the body downwards. What is mg cos theta doing? Mg cos theta is pushing the inclined plane. That's what it is doing, no? Inclined plane is like this. Mg cos theta is like this. It means it is pushing the inclined plane. Clear now? So mg cos theta is the weight component which is applying force on the inclined plane. Then according to Newton's third law, inclined plane also will give a reaction. And inclined plane will give reaction in which direction? Same direction or opposite direction? Newton's law is always applied in opposite direction. Reaction is always applied in opposite direction. So therefore, the inclined plane will apply same equal and opposite force, which is called mg cos theta. Okay, ma? So mg cos theta is the force with which 5 kg body is pushing the inclined plane. And inclined plane will give a reaction. Reaction is given on which body? Reaction a body pain is tundadi. Reaction is given on 5 kg body. Are you able to understand? So this reaction mg cos theta is given on 5 kg body. Now if you see here, this mg cos theta and this mg cos theta, these are the two forces which are pulling this 5 kg body, no ma? So this mg cos theta is trying to pull like this. This mg cos theta is trying to pull it in upwards direction. Both are equal and opposite, no? That is the reason why 5 kg body doesn't move in the direction perpendicular to contact surface. Body is always moving in which direction? It is moving parallel to contact surface or parallel to inclined plane. Kani ilagani move outer ledu kada adi. It is not moving perpendicular to contact surface or parallel to in downwards direction also. It is not moving in this direction or in this direction. What is the reason? Because both forces, they are balanced. This mg cos theta, they are balanced. They are cancelling with each other. Okay, ma? But is there any force to cancel mg sin theta? Mg sin theta ni cancel chayataniki force emi ledu. Okay, ma? So that is why mg cos theta becomes unbalanced force. Mg cos theta will become what kind of force? Unbalanced force. And unbalanced force is nothing but net force. Net force always produces acceleration. Are you able to understand? That is the reason why body has accelerated in downwards direction. Okay, ma? See here, mg cos theta, it is a balanced force. Somebody is cancelling that one. But there is no force to cancel mg sin theta. So it becomes the unbalanced force, or you can call it as net force. Net force always produces acceleration. Because of net force only, velocity of the body continuously increases or decreases also. Understood, no ma? That's it. So I will give you one more question, try to answer. So this is a wedge, ma, or an inclined plane, which is making an angle of theta. And on this wedge, there is a mass of small u. Mass of the wedge is capital M. Mass of the small block is small u. Clear, ma? See, ma, there is no friction. In between capital M and small m, there is no friction. Friction is not present. So if I don't apply any force and if I release this body, then what will happen? This body starts coming down. This body starts moving in backwards direction. Okay? This is not a fixed one. Idi kindiki raadam start avuthe, idi venikki velladam start avuthe. Clear? But what I am doing, I am applying some force such that, so small m is always unrest with respect to capital M. Are you able to understand? No? So what is the amount of force which you have to apply such that small m will be always in rest position with respect to capital M? It means that both of them, they should start moving like a single body. There should not be any sliding between small m and capital M. Clear, ma? Then what is the amount of force I have to apply? That is the question. Clear? Come on. Small m should not slip on capital M. It means both of them, they should move like a single body. That is the meaning of this question, no? Okay. So therefore, if they are moving like a single body, then why don't I apply the force F is equals to M plus M into A? Definitely I can apply this formula, no? Because on both these bodies, the only force which is acting is F. This is the only force which is acting, no? Frictions are also not present. There is no friction between a capital M and small m. There is no friction between capital M and ground also. Frictional forces ekkada manam teeskotam ledu kada. It means the only force which is acting on this total system is F only. So therefore F becomes the net force, and net force formula is mass into acceleration. So what is the mass of total system? M plus M. So M plus M, acceleration is A. This is the equation first we are supposed to write. So on this total system, this is the only force which is acting, and that becomes the net force. net force is equal to mass into acceleration. Net force formula, mass into acceleration only. So total mass of the system, m plus m. So m plus m, acceleration is, this is my equation. Clear now? Now if I calculate the acceleration of the system and substitute in this equation, then I will get the value of force. Now what is the, my next step? Next step is calculating what is the acceleration with which these bodies are moving. Are you able to understand? Okay. See, my here, on this block, let us draw a separate diagram. So consider this is the inclined plane. And on this inclined plane, this mass of small m is present. Okay? See, my, this block will move in this direction. Small m will move in this direction along with capital M. Okay? Now, who is pushing this small m? Small m ni push chestunnadi evaru? Who is pushing small m? This block, is it coming downwards? No, it should not come downwards. But it should move in which direction? It should move in this direction. And it should accelerate also. Clear nama? If a small m is accelerating in this direction, somebody is applying force on small m. Who is that? Normal reaction between what and what? First of all, I can say capital M is pushing small m. This force is not directly acting on small m. E force ever pain apply avutundi? Capital M pain. Who is pushing small m? Capital M. Capital M is pushing small m. How it is able to push? Ela push chestundi? Chetulu unnaya? How it is able to push? It is able to push because of normal reaction. Clear nama? In between two surfaces, always normal reaction will be there. No? So because of that normal reaction only, this capital M is able to push the small m. Are you able to understand? No? So therefore, this is the normal reaction. Are you able to understand? Now, normal reaction is not present in parallel to contact surface. Are you able to understand now? So what I will do, I will try to split this normal reaction into two components. Clear? Let us see. So what is the given angle? Given angle is angle theta, no? Are you able to understand? Now, this normal reaction, it is perpendicular to the contact surface. Similarly, if I try to draw one more line perpendicular to this ground, then this will become my line, no? What is this line? This is the line which is perpendicular to the ground. And what is this line? This is the line which is perpendicular to the contact surface. So here if angle is theta, then angle between the perpendiculars also will be theta according to geometry. Are you able to understand? So therefore this normal reaction, now I can split into two components. No? How can I split into two components? This is how I can split this one into two components. Clear number? And splitting, I am not able, I will not explain you. You have to study the splitting. Clear number? So adjacent side will become n cos theta, opposite side will become n sin theta. Correct only? No? So, first of all, normal reaction is the force which is pushing this small m. Normal reaction, again I have split into two components. If this angle is theta, definitely this angle is also theta. Why this is theta and this is also theta? You try to prove geometrically. Meere try cheyandi that. Artham avutundi kada? Okay. Now, I have split this normal reaction into n cos theta and n sin theta. Now, can you say, what is the work of n sin theta? What is n sin theta doing on small m? Accelerating. See, see the direction of n sin theta. N sin theta is in this direction, no? Body is also moving in the same direction, no? It means n sin theta is the force which is responsible to push this small m. And that is the only force which is acting on small m in this direction, no? So n sin theta becomes the net force. Net force formula? Mass into acceleration. So therefore I will write n sin theta is the only force which is pushing this small m in horizontal direction. So n sin theta becomes net force in horizontal direction, and net force becomes mass into acceleration again in horizontal direction. So what is the acceleration we have taken in horizontal direction? A. We are assuming that this total system, it is accelerating in this direction with an acceleration of n. So small m also will have same acceleration, no? Because both of them, they are behaving like a single body. A system acceleration A unte, small m acceleration kuda A ne unte, because both of them they are behaving like a single body. Are you able to understand, ma? So therefore, n sin theta is equals to mass into acceleration. This is my first step. Clear? Now can you say what is n cos theta doing? N sin theta is pushing this small m. n cos theta ఏం చేస్తుంది n cos theta what is n cos theta n cos theta is balancing weight of this small mg no ma small mg small m weight will be acting in which direction towards the center of earth and see the direction of n cos theta they are exactly in opposite direction it means weight mg is balanced by n cos theta why it is balanced because he already said in the question small m should not slip small m should not slip atta the kindiki raagudu akade undali Are you able to understand, ma? It should be present there only. It means vertical forces must be balanced. If mg is greater than n cos theta, body will come downwards. If n cos theta is greater than mg, body will move upwards. Clear, no? But if both of them they are equal, then only it will be in the same position in vertical direction. Okay. So definitely, I can say n cos theta is balancing what, ma? Is balancing the weight of small m. Okay. So n. N is an unknown quantity, no? Normal reaction is how much? I don't know. So what I will do? I will divide both of them. So N sin theta divided by N cos theta is equal to MA divided by MG. So mass, mass if they get cancelled. So therefore, A is equals to G tan theta. So this is my acceleration. It means that if I accelerate this system with this much amount of acceleration, then small m will be at rest with capital artham avutundi kadamma so this is the condition when all the forces when they are balanced no mg is balanced by n cos theta it means definitely body is in rest position with respect to capital m but both of them they are moving with respect to capital m small m is in rest position what is the meaning of this one see there is an observer standing on capital m and he is observing small m oka observer capital m paina nilabadukoni small m ni chustunnadu anukunte then to this observer small m always appears to be in rest position only no observer ki small m ela ganipistundi it appears always it is in rest position that's the same condition we are doing no are you able to understand but to the observer present on the ground lo nilabadi chuse vaadiki it appears as if small m and capital m both they are moving okay and to this observer also small m appears to be in rest position in vertical direction vertical direction lo daniki moment ledu it means all the vertical forces they must be balanced are you able to understand that's it very simple so therefore this is the acceleration with which I have to accelerate this system so that small m will be in at rest with respect to capital m okay so therefore just now substitute here so therefore what is the required force m plus m into a value was the only unknown quantity to know ma a value is g tan theta so this is my answer clear no ma So this much amount of force if I apply here then small m remains to be on capital m even without a friction friction lekapoyina adalage rest lo fine that's clear ma come on same type of question almost see here so this car it is accelerating in this direction no ma and on this inclined plane there is a mass of small m okay So therefore, you just draw the normal reaction acting on small m. Okay, ma? Small m is present like this, and this is the direction of normal reaction. Clear? No? Inclined plane is making how much angle? It is making an angle of theta. Clear? No? So split this normal reaction into two components. Clear? So if this angle is theta, definitely this angle also will be theta only. So this is n cos theta adjacent side, and opposite side is what? Opposite side is n. sin theta clear no now this n sin theta it is acting in this direction this is the direction of n sin theta no ma clear no so what is n sin theta doing n sin theta is the force which is an unbalanced force there is no force to balance this n sin theta so n sin theta will produce acceleration on this small m ee small m paine kada id act avutunnadi so danna ade accelerate chestundi and acceleration value only we are supposed to calculate clear no ma So therefore, I will say n sin theta is accelerating small m. So therefore, that is the net force, and net force is equal to mass into acceleration. That is the only force which is acting on small m in horizontal direction. A direction lo inka vere velocity ledu kada. Clear? So another force is not present. Now, what is n cos theta doing? N cos theta should have been balancing weight of the body mg, which is always acting downwards. That's all. So therefore, n cos theta is equal to mg. So mass and mass get cancelled if I divide both of them. Clear number. So therefore again I got tan theta is equals to a by g. So therefore a is equals to g tan theta. Exactly the same answer which I got in the previous condition. Okay. So therefore on an inclined plane, if there is no friction and if body should not slip, then I have to push the body with how much acceleration? With an acceleration of g tan theta. So direct answer you can remember. Okay, but a is equal to g tan theta is satisfied in which condition? Only if there is no friction. If there is friction, that's another equation we will get. We will discuss that one in friction topic. Fine, ma? Come on, make a note. Okay, ma? See, ma, let us try to understand what is the question first of all. Ashish anmata. Clear? దొంగతనం చేస్తాడు పోలీస్ వాళ్ళ ఇంట్లో. పోలీస్ ఏం చేస్తాడంటే బాక్స్లో నిలబెట్టి పైన రూఫ్కు కట్టి కింద మంట పెట్టాడు అన్నమాట. క్లియర్? బాక్సు ఒక రోప్ని పుల్లి ద్వారా పాస్ చేసి ఆ రోప్ను ఆశీష్ చేతికి ఇచ్చినాడు. మళ్ళీ వదిలినావా, కింద పడతావు, పోతావు అంటే. ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ద సిచ్యువేషన్? So man is present inside the box. So there is a rope which is passing through the pulley and the rope is again given to the hands of this person only. Are you able to understand? So he should hold the rope with a particular force. He should apply some force on the rope. Otherwise, if he leaves the rope, what will happen? The box will fall down. That is the condition. Okay? If this person leaves this box will fall down. Are you able to understand? So therefore, these are the different conditions which I am supposed to do. So mass of the man is 60, mass of the box is 40, and system should be in rest position. Clear? Then what is the force man should apply on the rope? Man should pull the rope with how much force? Second question is, what is the normal reaction acting on the man? Who will give normal reaction on the man? Box will give the normal reaction because he is pulling the rope, no? Rope box also will push him in upward direction. So these two values I am supposed to calculate. Is it clear, ma'am? So with only one particular force, he has to pull the rope such the total system is in equilibrium. Okay, now let us see. So first of all, how I try to do this problem is, ma'am, in Newton's laws, everything depends on free body diagrams. How you are able to represent all the forces which are acting on a system. Okay, if you are able to represent all the forces accurately, then very easily you can do the problem. You should represent all the forces and their directions also in correct manner. Clear? Now let us. So here basically two bodies are there, Nama. One is man. Ashish Vidyarthi unnadu akkadu. Ashish 60 kg untavu nu. Undavu. Okay, ma? So one body is man itself and another body is the lift. Clear? Two bodies are there. And here both the bodies are in rest only, no? Man is also in rest position. Box is also in rest position. It means that net force acting on any body should be zero. That's all. Net force acting on any body should be zero. That is why they are in rest position. Okay. If on one body if there is net force, body will accelerate. No? But there are no net forces which are acting in this direction. Okay. Now let us. So first of all, I will draw the free body diagram of man. Clear, ma? So consider this is man. So on man, how many forces are acting, can you say? On this man, how many forces are acting? First of all, his own weight will act in downwards direction, no? What weight one kindiki lagutu untundi kada? First of all, his own weight. What is the mass of the person? 60. So weight is equals to 60 into 10. 600 newtons will be the weight of this body. Clear, no? And here, see, ma, this person, he is pulling the rope downwards. రోప్ని కిందికి కదా లాగుతూ ఉండాలి వాడు, లేదంటే పోతాడు పైకి, కింద పడిపోతాడు అన్నమాట. క్లియర్వా? హీ ఈస్ పుల్లింగ్ ద రోప్ డౌన్వర్డ్స్. బై న్యూటన్స్ థర్డ్ లా, రోప్ ఈస్ పుల్లింగ్ ద మ్యాన్ ఇన్ అప్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్. మ్యాన్ ఈస్ అప్లయింగ్ ఫోర్స్ ఆన్ ద రోప్ ఇన్ డౌన్వర్డ్స్ డైరెక్షన్. రోప్ పైన ఫోర్స్ ఎలా ఉంది? కిందికి. బై న్యూటన్స్ థర్డ్ లా, రోప్ ఈస్ పుల్లింగ్ ద మ్యాన్ ఇన్ అప్వర్డ్స్ డైరెక్షన్. దట్ ఈస్ న్యూటన్స్ థర్డ్ లా. నమ్మా, ఎవ్రీ యాక్షన్ హ్యాస్ అన్ ఈక్వల్ అండ్ ఆపోజిట్ రియాక్షన్. సో దేర్ ఫోర్ if the tension in the rope is T, then what is the tension doing? Tension is pulling the man in upwards direction. Are you able to understand? And some of his weight will fall on the box. No? Some of the weight of the man falls on the box. Total weight will not fall. The total weight of the man does not fall on the box. What is the reason? Because tension is also pulling him in upward direction. Are you able to understand? Only some of the weight of the man falls on the box. Then what box will do? Box will give a normal reaction. And that is that normal reaction. So these are 1, 2, 3 forces which are acting on the man. Are you able to understand what is happening? So what are the different forces? First one is weight of the man. Weight is always pulling him downwards. No? One weight. Total weight will not fall on the box. See, if I am standing like this, without holding anything, then my total weight falls on the ground. And the ground also will give equal amount of normal reaction. But nenu oka thaadunu pattukoni nilabadukoni unnanu ankonde, then my total weight doesn't fall on the ground. Same concept here also. Man is holding a rope. So his total weight will not fall on the box. Only some weight will fall. And box will give same amount of normal reaction. And how much is that normal reaction? Still I don't know. Are you able to understand? So, but normal reaction will be in which direction on the man? In upwards direction. Because man will push the box downwards. Box will push the man in upwards direction. So that is the normal reaction which is acting in upward direction. Forces anni artham avutunnayi kada, ye force em pan chestundi. Clear ma? So this is the free body diagram of the man. And man, is he in rest position or is he accelerating ma? He is in rest position. It means upward forces and downward forces must be balanced. That's all. Pairuna forces, kindana forces and balance I povali. Clear? So therefore, can I say that n plus t is equal to 600? N and t acting in which direction? Upward direction. Weight is acting in which direction? So these two should balance 600, no? Because man is in rest position, and it means all the forces should be balanced. Clear now? So therefore, this is my first equation, equation number 1. Clear? Now I will draw the free body diagram of the box. Free body diagram of box. Clear? So this is the box. On box, how many forces are acting? First of all, box has a mass, no? So then what is the weight of the box? 400 Newton. So weight of the box of 400 Newton is acting in downwards direction. Clear? Still. Here there is a rope in which a tension is T is acting, no? This is the same rope, no? Same rope. So here if tension is T, here also tension will be T. And what is this tension doing? Here there is rope and rope is pulling the box in upward direction, no? So therefore on this box, tension T is acting in upward direction. Clear, no? Still, is there any other force? Inka yavana forces unna, inka yavana? Some of the weight of the man is falling on the box, no? Okay, ma? And that is the reason why box has given a normal reaction. It means same normal reaction will be acting in which direction on the box? In downwards direction. This is the action, this is the reaction. Are you able to understand? Some of the weight of the man falls on the box. Box pane kindi push chestundi kada. And what box will do? Box will give a normal reaction on the man. So this force and this force, they are exactly equal and opposite. Total weight is not falling on the box. Box pain or total weight pattern ledhu, koncheme padutundi. Why? Because already he is holding a rope. No? Are you able to understand? No? That's it. Now, box is also in rest position. No? It means again all these forces, they must be balanced with each other. So I can write tension should be balancing this force and this force. So 400 plus n. Clear? No? This is my second equation. What is the first equation I got? First equation I got is n plus t 600. Take this t value, substitute here. So therefore, n plus, instead of t, I can write 400 plus n is equal to 600. So 2n is equals to 600 minus 400 is equal to 200. So therefore, what is n value? N value is 100 Newton. Okay, ma? So what is meant by n value? So out of total 600 Newton of the weight of the man, 100 Newtons is falling on the box. What is the weight of the man? 600 Newton. Kani box pain enta weight padutundi? Only 100 Newton. Then box will give how much normal reaction? Box also will give 100 Newton normal reaction. That's it. Ante vadi total weight box paina button ledhu. Clear namma? So once I calculate normal reaction, I can calculate tension also. No? take this normal reaction, substitute here. So therefore, retention is equals to 400 plus 100. So how much? 500 Newton. So this is the tension acting in the rope. Tension acting in the rope is nothing but force applied by the man on the rope. Asal dantlo tension enduku act avutundi? Because man is applying force on the rope. Clear namma? So force applied by the man on the rope is nothing but tension. Tension is how much? 500. That's all. This is how we do the calculations. Are you able to understand, ma? So Newton's laws will become very easy if you can identify all the forces which are acting. Are you able to understand, ma? And if you can correctly manipulate which force is doing which work, then very easily you can do the problems. Okay, ma? So drawing this free body diagrams is the only point which you should remember, and all these are mathematical calculations. Fine? That's it.